Continuing the letter diplomacy, Prime Minister Narendra Modi responded to a letter written to him by Pakistan Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said he's looking forward to working closely with him and his government in an atmosphere free from confrontation and violence. Thanking Nawaz Sharif for his participation in the ceremony for the swearing-in of the new government, PM Modi wrote, "I was also encouraged by our discussions on our bilateral relations and the convergence in our views. I look forward, therefore, to working closely with you and your government in an atmosphere free from confrontation and violence in order to chart a new course in our bilateral relations." He went on to condemn the terrorist attack in Karachi and concluded by thanking the Pakistan PM for the sari that he sent for his mother.
"Our policy towards our neighbors has always been to work towards peaceful and cordial relations. So that is our overall objective, and that is where the sari and the shawl diplomacy and the letter diplomacy fits in."
But even as the Prime Minister expressed his desire to work with Pakistan in a peaceful atmosphere, Pakistani troops violated the ceasefire targeting Indian posts along the LOC in Poonch sector of Jammu and Kashmir. Heavy firing and mortar shelling from across the border drew a retaliation by Indian forces. The Foreign Ministry maintained that peace along the border was a prerequisite to cordial relations between the two countries.
"On the firing, I would just like to reiterate that peace and tranquility on the border is of the highest importance in establishing the preconditions for such a peaceful and normal relationship."
Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister Omar Abdullah tweeted, questioning the timing of the ceasefire violation. Defence Minister Arun Jaitley is scheduled to visit the state on Saturday to review the security situation. While the left condemned Pakistan's double standards, the Congress party used the opportunity to attack the BJP government.
"आज इस देश के प्रधानमंत्री ने सेना के तीनों अध्यक्षों की और राष्ट्रीय सुरक्षा सलाहकार की बैठक बुला के स्थिति की समीक्षा का एक निर्णय लिया था, और जिस दिन वो समीक्षा बैठक कर रहे हैं उसी दिन पाकिस्तान की तरफ से इस तरह की हरकत, मैं समझता हूं कि ये एक खुली चुनौती है।
दिस इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल एंड इट इज डेप्लोरेबल। पाकिस्तान गवर्नमेंट, द सिविलियन गवर्नमेंट शुड टेक नोट ऑफ दिस एंड act in an appropriate manner, how to stop all these provocations and how to honor the ceasefire between our two countries."
Defense experts too condemned the attack, blaming Pakistan for not being able to control terrorism.
"Defeat the purpose of Nawaz Sharif talk. The other power centers which are more powerful than Nawaz Sharif's center of power, which is Pakistan Army, ISI on one hand, and the Jihad factory, particularly Lashkar-e-Toyba, the groups that are still under the control of ISI, they are planning to defeat Nawaz Sharif's talks and peace talks, and they have increased their infiltration attempts on the border."
"It's sirf ek attack nahi hua, isme aaj aur bhi ho rahe hain, abhi bhi attack ho rahe hain, aur jo saaf pata lagta hai कि जो नवाज शरीफ है वो कंट्रोल में नहीं है। आपने देखा है कि कराची में अभी अटैक हुआ है, तो अगर वो अपने एयरपोर्ट्स पे नहीं रोक सकते तो वो हमें कहां। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द मेन थिंग इज कि नवाज शरीफ टुडे इज नॉट इन कंट्रोल।
Between the end of April and mid-May, 19 incidents of ceasefire violation were reported from across the LOC in this area. That the intent of both the Indian Prime Minister and the Pakistani Prime Minister is to move towards better relations between the two countries is evident. At this juncture, repeated ceasefire violations send out confusing signals. The question is, will India and Pakistan give meaningful dialogue a chance? DD News.